What do you mean you can't open the gate? Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper.
Hey there.
Better buy my big guns now, because you bet your ass your enemies will.
What kind of stuff do you have?
If it can chamber cock and spit out lead, then I sell it. I sell slashers and clobberers, too, for those maniacs that like it up close. But hot death flying faster than the speed of sound? Oh, my knees are getting weak just from thinking about it.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Just think how damn good it'll feel holding one of these.
Hi. Stick to the roads, and you got a better chance of surviving.
Open up.
You. You want into Diamond City, right?
I just got here, but yeah.
What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. I need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
You first.
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrap for parts.
Mr. McDonough, tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster.
Newspapers just like to stir up trouble.
A fair point, sir, but I believe it depends on the reporter. Exposing the truth is one thing. Twisting it is another.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, good sir. No. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money, settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
I'm sure your city's a great place.
Yeah, greatest house of cards in the Commonwealth. Until the wind blows.
Now, Was there anything particular you came to our city for?
I'm trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
My son, Sean. He's less than a year old.
Wait, your son's missing? Oh, you hear that, McDonough? What's Diamond City Security doing to help this man, huh? This isn't the first missing persons report to come through here, and now we have an infant who's been taken?
Don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help you.
Well, sure. And a mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, there is one private citizen, Nick Valentine, a detective of sorts who specializes in tracking people down, usually for debts or whatnot. Now, I have to get going. I'm sorry, Diamond City Security doesn't have time to help, but I'm sure Mr. Valentine charges a reasonable fee.
This is ridiculous. Diamond City Security can't spare one officer to help. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security never investigates any cases?
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. I'm impressed. Not everyone can claw information out of McDonough's tight-fisted hands. Why don't you stop by my office after you see Valentine? I think I just found my next story.
Officer?
Head on inside.
Danny.
So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about. Something tells me she's pulled the...
So, this is the famous Diamond City. I suppose I hope to find more of a gem than a dusty home base. Civilization in the rough, if you will.
Pipe! Thank you.
Piper, you're back.
Hey, kiddo. How are the paper sales?
Well, the presses are getting overloaded. That motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it.
You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Piper?
Free paper to newcomers. If the Institute grabs you in the night, at least we warned you.
A free paper? Sounds like quality.
I'm serious. The Institute takes people. You should read up if you're sticking around.
I believe you. Thanks.
You're a real lost lamb in the wolf's den, mister. Get your copy of the public. We expose the truth behind the Institute.
First time. Just try to keep it down.
Not sure what God I'm supposed to be praying to. Castor says it doesn't matter.
Hey.
Sir?
Not sure which God I'm supposed to be praying to.
Pastor.
Good to see someone new in the chapel. Diamond City treating you all right?
I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
You're welcome. Old folks are taking well to you. I know it can be rough being from the outside. Now, if you ever need a quiet place to sit down and ponder the Almighty in whatever form strikes your fancy, we're always open.
So, you don't practice any particular religion here?
As long as you believe in something, you're welcome. Diamond City is full of people trying to build a better life. I just don't want them to forget what makes them human while they're at it. So the chapel is open, 24 hours a day, to whatever form of worship you like, long as it's peaceful.
Thanks, Pastor.
Feel free to make yourself at home.
If you're here to pray, sit down and be quiet.
Hey, Piper.
Glad you dropped by. You holding up, Lou?
Why are you calling me that?
Because you're a vault dweller? I know you're not wearing a blue jumpsuit right now, but the Pip-Boy and the fish out of water look... dead giveaways. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. I think it's time Diamond City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. You do that, and I'll tell you what. I'll come with you. Watch your back while you get used to the world above ground.
What kind of interview is this gonna be?
I ask you who you are, get your opinion on life out there, and maybe load up a few tough questions and keep it interesting. What do you say?
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My family and I were frozen. I didn't spend much time in the vault.
Wait, they boxed you up in a fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive before the war?
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
Oh my god. The man out of time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to your old life?
You're all living in rusty shacks, killing each other. My god, the smell.
Okay. Well, that's gonna be a fun one to quote. Now, I already know you're looking for your son, Sean. Do you suspect the Institute was involved in his kidnapping?
I don't know.
No one ever does. That's what makes them so scary. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
No matter how much you want to give up, don't. You have to have hope that you'll see them again. Or at least, that you'll know the truth.
A strong note to end on, Blue. Thanks. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right? Watch your back? Just say the word when you're ready. I can't wait to see where the story goes next. Stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say. Maybe constantly trying to kill us, but the Commonwealth never lacks for excitement.
Piper.
Head my way?
You sure you want to travel with me?
Well, it's that, or get back to writing the paper. I guess the paper can wait.
Sure, let's go.
Will do.
Miss Wright, I trust you'll do your best to put the safety of my master before your own personal gain.
Of course, Codsworth. Jesus. Lucky for me, those two things go hand in hand.
Uh-huh.
hard to believe I'm roaming with my own pre-war relic. What'd they use you for? It's big, loud, full of corrupt officials and brown-nosing citizens, but it's home.
Anyone is one of those things, it's that secretary of his, her, and her perfect hair.
The mayor's secretary, come on, Ma.
I ain't telling you how to pick your friends, but Piper's kind of a troublemaker.
That's just it, Johnny. You wouldn't be able to tell the difference. If you nick McDonough with your razor, he'd bleed. Don't mean nothing.
Well, hello
looking
there.
For a haircut. The salon's
another
open.
One of the poor and stupid of Diamond City come begging for table scraps?
Wow. There are no words.
I don't care for your tone. Why don't you run along before I make a complaint with security?
Bitch.
What did you say? Oh, whatever. I'm done talking to you.
Do yourself a favor and just say yes. It's all he understands.
Newcomer, huh? Talk to Abbott at the wall, if you want a history lesson.
Hey.
You say the word.
Piper.
Something you need?
Is everything okay between us?
It's hard to say at the moment. I think I need you to show me you're not just out here for yourself.
Your thoughts?
Most folks are just looking for a hand. All we gotta do is offer.
Oh, nothing.
Sure.
Dad says not to talk to strangers.
Hey there. You should stop by my stall in the morning. Commonwealth Weaponry.
My brother.
I swear, I'm not a simp. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family!
Put the gun down, now!
He's a simp! He'll kill us all!
Kyle, no!
Okay, show's over. There are no simps in Diamond
City.
The gun
off.
Hear me?
Just
you folks and your damn paranoia.
What happened?
I'm not a synth. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me? I need a minute.
Everyone's still standing around for it. Go back to your own damn business.
Blue, can I get a minute? Something I need to do. Excuse me. Question for you. Tell me, do you think I'm worried about the possible infiltration of Diamond City's ruling elite by synths?
One day my daughter's gonna pick up the mantle.
Yeah, Piper, I am. But I ain't buying your lousy newspaper.
Oh, well, thanks. I guess.
Heads up.
What's going on?
Sometimes you gotta wonder, does anyone fight back? Institute has to have enemies, right?
What? You mean the railroad?
That's a fairy tale, man. They don't exist.
He knows a guy that works for him. They got a code frame.
Told you your luck wouldn't last forever. His ties.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing.
Nikki's missing? What has he gotten himself into this time?
Don't worry, I can help. Tell me what happened.
Nick was working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there that they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Hey, I'd love to help, but there's a small matter of expenses.
Money, huh? I do have 125 caps in the old rainy day fund.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry. follow you outside and wear such funny clothes?
See those big lights? That's right. Working electricity.
So I'm keeping an eye on those mutant freaks over at Trinity, and this guy comes out of nowhere sprinting down the road. I know he must have seen him standing there from way down the street, but he didn't slow down or even duck into one of the alleys.
Ah!
I got it. Jesus. Why are you losing such a bad one?
That's why I'm still alive.
Other side's chained up.
You're sorry ass to watch my back. That's why I'm trying to keep you alive, too. Enough yapping already. Somebody could be sneaking up on us right now.
Whatever you say, boss.
Chained up on the other side.
What the hell was that? What the fuck was that? Where'd that little fucker go?
No sign of him now.
That's fine.
Hey, let's go eat. I'm starving.
You can eat when I'm damn sure we're not about to get jumped.
I got it.
What was that? Who's there?
Thank you.
You see that?
Who's there?
That's in better shape than I expected.
Hey.
What you got for me? Something you need?
Your thoughts?
Doing the right thing rarely makes you popular. But I don't think I could live with myself otherwise.
Nothing else for now.
Sure.
Thank you.
Walking right into Boston Commons. People don't come back from here. We're walking right into Boston Commons. People don't come back from here.